Imperial College in the UK is on the leading edge in the search for new energy sources. And in its quest to find our future fuels, it is focused on an old world essential.
Wood, it turns out, actually is a very good source of fuels and chemicals. You just need to take it apart in the right way.
The right way involves heat, pressure, and to continuously pump a thick wood slurry into the reactor. At first, that was a problem, but then Dr. Tai remembered the performance of pumps he had used in the past.
We used them when I was a postdoc at UCL to inject slurries into a hydrothermal reactor to make materials. So when we had a problem of how to inject slurries into this reactor, of course, ISCO was the first thing that came to mind.
The process places tremendous pressure on the equipment. Pressure that is necessary to separate the chemicals and fuels from the wood.
That's what's quite hard in this case, is because we go up to 250 bar, which is quite tricky in terms of safety and performance. So yeah, we will be able to pump those.
Dr. Tai and his Imperial College team have been successful in extracting biochemicals, fuels, and synthesizing the materials for batteries. The key to that success is having the right equipment to make the process continuous and take their work to the next level.
That reaction, which is taking minutes or hours in batch, will take less than a second or maybe a few seconds in this reaction.
Dr. Tai believes the difference will lead to more discoveries and possibly a sustainable fuel source. But he must focus on the present and finding the right equipment that will help his team find the key that unlocks the future.
I mean, the reason that ISCOs are so useful around the lab is that they're simple. We can maintain them ourselves. So we tend to push pumps to their very limits of application.
We are proud Imperial College uses our equipment and will continue to make the pumps that can handle the pressure the reactions need.
Reliably, also, it's quite hard since we're pumping to such high pressures. Obviously, it's been handling throughout the whole operating range that we desire.
According to Dr. Tai, continuous pressure is the key to finding a sustainable fuel to power the world.